Today, I'll show you how to install WordPress on all of the most popular web hosting providers. I'll leave timestamps for every single provider in the description so you can find the one that you're using and skip ahead. I'll do Hostinger, SiteGround, Bluehost, A2 Hosting, HostGator, DreamHost, and InterServer. So, let's start. First off, it's Hostinger, in my opinion, one of the best web hosting providers in 2020 because they're extremely cheap, use the latest technology for their servers, and more importantly, they're an independent company. When you buy your hosting plan from Hostinger, your dashboard will look something like this. To install WordPress, all you need to do is click Manage, scroll down to Auto Installers, and choose WordPress. Fill in all of this information, mainly your username and password to log in into WordPress, and click Install. After a couple of minutes, you will be able to reach your WordPress dashboard by clicking here and then edit website. But I recommend typing in /wp-admin after your website name in the address bar for faster access in the future. And that's pretty much it. If you're interested, you can get a 4-year web hosting plan with Hostinger by spending just around $40 together with a website name by using the links down in the description below. SiteGround is also a very modern web hosting provider packed with extra security features and a bunch of extra quirks to make managing your website as easy as possible. So installing WordPress will be absolutely a breeze. Here's how you do it. From your dashboard, click Websites and choose a new website. If you already have a domain name, click Existing Domain and type in your website name, then click Continue. Choose Start a New Website option and click on WordPress. Think of the login information that you'll use to log into your WordPress account and finally click Finish. After the installation is done, you can find all of your websites created with SiteGround by clicking on the Websites tab. And next to your website, just click the WordPress kit and then go to WordPress admin. For faster access, you can also type in your website name in the address bar followed by /wp-admin and logging in using the WordPress credentials. SiteGround is an excellent web hosting provider that's extremely fast, reliable, and packed with features, but it's a bit on the expensive side. However, if you've got the money, the hundreds of dollars a year are highly worth it. I'll also leave discount links for SiteGround in the description down below. Next in line, we have Bluehost, quite a cheap, beginner-friendly option, so let's see how hard or how easy it is to install WordPress using Bluehost. The process is really simple. Just click on My Sites, then click the Create button. Type in the website name you would like to use, then click on Advanced and choose the login information for your WordPress dashboard. After that, click Next, and I recommend you deselect all of these extra options, then choose the website name you would like your WordPress to be installed on, and click Next. The rest is done completely automatically in a minute or two. Now you can click on the Login to WordPress button or just use your website name followed by /wp-admin to log in. Bluehost offers relatively cheap web hosting plans that are best suited for web hosting beginners. You can get a 3-year web hosting plan for your website by spending just around $100. I'll leave discount links in the description below as always. At the moment of making this video, A2 Hosting is offering by far the fastest shared web hosting plans, but their control panel, well, it's a bit outdated and clunky. So here's how we install WordPress on A2 Hosting, the easy way. Once inside your A2 Hosting panel, click on the green cPanel button, and then click on the WordPress A2 Optimized option. Make sure it says A2 Optimized because that's the one that comes with custom optimization tools developed by A2 Hosting. Then click on the blue install button and fill out this information with your website name, description, and the login information you want to use for your WordPress dashboard. Now simply click on the install button and wait. And of course, as with other web hosting providers, you can reach your WordPress dashboard by typing in your website name followed by /wp-admin and using the WordPress login information. Super easy. If you're interested in the fastest possible website while using shared web hosting services, A2 Hosting plans start at around $100 for a 3-year period with the discounts that you can find in the description below. In my opinion, HostGator plans are one of the worst in terms of hosting in 2020 out of all of the legit providers. Of course, there are a ton of like less legit providers that are worse than HostGator, but in my opinion, it's only worth to use HostGator plans if you score a big discount during Black Friday sales or just promotions in general. But anyways, let me show you how to install WordPress on HostGator. To install WordPress on HostGator, you have two options. But first, let me show you why I say they're one of the worst choices for you when it comes to 2020. If I click on cPanel, I get this screen. It's just completely broken, and HostGator breaks a lot. Luckily, there's a secondary option. Once you're in the dashboard, click on Install WordPress and then click Install WordPress again. Here, HostGator will try to sell you some extra crap. Just ignore it and click Install WordPress for the third time. Choose the domain name and fill out all of these details. Then click Install WordPress. Yeah, for the fourth time. Now, HostGator will try to sell you some extra features for the second time. Just choose no thanks. Here you can find the login information at the top. Make sure to save the password, as HostGator doesn't even show it ever again. As I mentioned before, I'm not a big fan of HostGator, but you can still use them for learning, throwaway projects, or just side hustles if you manage to get a good deal. Here we have DreamHost, another quite cheap, stable, and reliable web hosting provider that I personally really enjoy using and recommend often. The installation process is incredibly simple, but it takes a while. As soon as you log in, you'll see this Install WordPress button. Just click on it and it's all done automatically from here on out. The installation will take around 10 to 15 minutes, and after it's done, you can reach your WordPress site by clicking on Domains, then Websites. And here you'll find every single website you have created with DreamHost. DreamHost is actually one of my personal favorite web hosting providers, and they're really cheap if you only need web hosting for like a month or a year. If you like what you're seeing here, I actually did a full review of DreamHost that you can find right around here. But for now, let's continue. And finally, we have InterServer. The InterServer control panel is quite old and clunky, but the service is overall great. Here's how to install WordPress on it. Start by clicking here. You'll see the name that you've registered your first website with. Next, click on the Login to cPanel button and scroll all the way down until you see WordPress. First of all, make sure that the directory line is empty. Then it's a business as usual. Just type in your website name and tagline, think of a username and password for your WordPress dashboard, and just scroll down to the bottom and hit the install button. After a couple of minutes, you'll be able to reach your WordPress dashboard by clicking here, or for future access, just type in your website name followed by slash wp-admin. InterServer is actually one of the only legit providers that do not increase your web hosting price after your first purchase ends. That means they have a price lock guarantee. The money that you pay first month is the money that you're gonna pay after a year or 2 years. If you want to get started with InterServer, I'll leave a discount in the description down below. But as you can see, installing WordPress with reputable providers in 2020 is extremely easy. Almost everything is completely automated, and you can have your website up and running in like 5 or 10 minutes. For now, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, hit that subscribe button. And good luck making your websites.